size for a pair of eyes of this bird, but what the heck. Sharpie marker. Just based on what I got out of this drawing, I just used the X just for the eyes of this bird. And, oh, what was missing? Oops, the feet. How did you get down there? It's supposed to be attached to here, right where the tail is. Well, don't worry. Even after the feet is on, it should be just as complete as it's going to get. Stubborn, isn't it? Jeez. Okay, well, the chest broke. It's not doing any good. So how much time is there left? Okay, thanks for the signal. Still, I'm gonna get the feet attached to this thing. I don't know what's the matter with the feet or the chest or whatever part you can name on this birdie. But whatever the reason, whatever the cause, with or without a yellow or a white or whatever color chest it's got, that's going to be as good as a bird is going to get, I guess. But using white or yellow doesn't matter. That's how the chest should be wrapped around in the front of this bird. Okay, so that was four birds, but then there's one more right on top of my head. And I'll sure go ahead and take it off and explain. Well, first off, simple. I start off with this yellow orange balloon where I do some loop twists and twist them together. And then this loop, you know, which is supposed to help you for the head. And as for the bird, Tweety, by the way, just took a 260 and then wrap it back here. And if memory serves, I had a piece of a 160 balloon where I just took it and twisted it so that it couldn't stand up, because if without that, it's going to end up falling backward, and I don't want that to be falling backward. And I used that same balloon too for the arms and hands and the rest of the body part. There's a loop right here and did loop twists, and I attached this orange, I think it's 160, and then simply touched the eyes there and then color them with black and added eyebrows. And plus there's a little twist in there so it stays, you know, face forward and all that. So if you try that, yeah, that could be a very good cartoon character bird that goes right onto your head. There's 4 minutes to go. Oh gosh, okay, with 4 minutes to go, what else could I do? Well, if I get lucky this time. Actually, that's not white, that was a clear. I was meant to pull out clear. If we're lucky, there could be one more thing maybe I could do. Or not. That was a big poof. Okay, so let's go ahead and make these two loop twists, followed by this. Oops, afraid to say this, but I think it's running out of air. Or it looked like it is. Yep, it's out of air. No good. Of course, if I don't, you know, get this made, you know, within 3 minutes, that's okay. I just thought, you know, for an extra time, I could go ahead and make another bird of some kind, which you'd be surprised. So again, I try to push through this thing. Okay, and we do this, and twist it. Probably you've learned how to do the parrot from some other episode some time ago. But the windbird I'm trying to go ahead and do is not actually a parrot, kind of like the parrot right here, or that basic parrot I showed you before. But it was meant to be, I believe it's going to be, a cockatiel. Now, I can't promise anything, but I'm just going to go ahead and see if I can make a black beak for this little birdie. That black balloon around its head. And let's see, is this good? Maybe it will be if I cut a little bit of it off. And toss the rest. And I just gotta open this up if I can. Okay, 1 minute to go. Thank you. Whether or not it's gonna turn out this perfect, it's. The next thing I was going to do, you know, for this birdie is going to be the, I guess it's a little head. Whether you think this is a cockatiel or just a little bird with a strange head over its head, doesn't matter to me how you look at it as. Just add a couple eyes to it. Bye-bye.